Hello students, welcome in e-learning class of St. Michael's Academy. I am Chandrishwar Kumar and I will teach Maths for Standard 11. Students, syllabus of Standard 11 is divided in 6 units. One is set and function, second is algebra, third is coordinate geometry, fourth is calculus, fifth is mathematical reasoning, and sixth is statics and probability. Students, we are going to start this session with second unit, which is algebra. In algebra, now in this session, we will study complex numbers. Why we are starting with complex numbers? Because in complex numbers, we have to know new concepts. We have to discuss about imaginary numbers. Students, already we know about real numbers, but there are also other numbers which are imaginary and we don't know. Imaginary numbers, what they are actually and how our calculation will be very easy. By knowing imaginary numbers, students, when we solve quadratic equations, sometimes we are not able to find out the real value of real solution of a quadratic equation. When we will know imaginary numbers, then we will be able to find out the solution of every quadratic equation. So let us know what is actually imaginary number. Students, you may have studied real numbers. Let us recap. What are real numbers? Real number is a combination of whole number, natural number, integers, rational numbers and irrational numbers. It means that group of whole numbers, natural numbers, rational numbers, integers and irrational numbers is called real number. There are some properties of real numbers which we should know. Students, square of any real number is always a positive number, positive real number. Means square of any real number will not be equal to a negative number. Always it will be positive or zero. And also square root of any real number will not be equals to negative. It will be always positive and zero. Students, there are some other numbers whose squares may be negative number or zero. And what are that numbers? Let us know. Students, that are imaginary numbers. Imaginary numbers are numbers whose square is a negative number or zero. So let us write definition of imaginary numbers. Imaginary number. A number whose square is either a negative number or जीरो। अ नंबर व्हिच स्क्वायर इज आइदर अ नेगेटिव नंबर और अ जीरो इज कॉल्ड एन इमेजिनरी नंबर। इमेजिनरी नंबर इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय अ ग्रीक लेटर आयोटा। इमेजिनरी नंबर इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय अ ग्रीक लेटर आई दैट इज कॉल्ड आयोटा एंड दिस इज इक्वल्स टू आई इक्वल्स टू अंडर रूट माइनस वन। आई इज फॉर व्हाट? आई इज फॉर अंडर रूट माइनस वन। आई इज इक्वल्स टू अंडर रूट माइनस वन एंड दिस इमेजिनरी नंबर आई इज फर्स्ट इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय आयलर। Let us discuss how square of this imaginary number I is a negative number. Students, under minus 1 equals to I. Under root minus 1 equals to I. Squaring on both sides we will get minus 1 equals to I square. Here what we are observing? We are observing that square of I is a negative number. And now we have studied that, we have studied discuss that square of imaginary numbers is a negative number or zero. A number whose square is negative number or zero is called an imaginary number. Here square of I is negative number, so I is an imaginary number. What about minus 2? This is an imaginary number or not? Let us find out. We can write under root 2, under root minus 2 as under root minus 1 into 2. And we can write it as under root minus 1 into under root 2. And we represent under root minus 1 as I. Write here I into under root 2. This is I under root 2. We can write under root minus 2 equals to I under root 2. And this is the imaginary number. Why? Because I is the imaginary number. Any number in the form I under root A, I A is called imaginary number. Any number together with I, any number together with I is also an imaginary number. Let us discuss some other properties of real numbers. Strength. For any two real numbers A and B, we can write under root A into under root B equals to under root AB, where both are positive numbers. Where both A and B are positive numbers, positive real numbers, then we can write under root A into under root B equals to under root AB. Also, for under root minus A into B, we can write it as under root minus AB. Under root minus under root A into under root minus B, we can write it as minus AB. But when both numbers are negative, then how can we write? Under root minus a, under root minus a into under root minus b. Since under root minus a into minus b. Students, be very careful here. Why? Students, since we know minus into minus gives plus, but in this case minus into minus will not be equal to plus. We will not write here like this one. Minus minus plus and a into b. Under root minus a into under root minus b will not be equal to under root ab. This will be wrong. We cannot write it as under root ab. So what we will write? Let us know. We will write it as under root minus 1 into a into minus 1 into b. Can we write? Yes, definitely we can write. And since we know under root minus 1 is I, this becomes like this. And I is under root minus 1 is equals to I. This is a, this is I, and this is under root b. And I into I will be equals to I square. This will be I square, and this will be equals to under root ab. Since we know I square is equals to minus 1. I square equals to minus 1. So we will write here minus 1 under root ab, and this will be equals to minus under root ab. So what will be the value of under root minus a into under root minus b? It will be equals to under root ab and here minus. This will be equals to minus under root ab. We cannot write it as under root ab only. This is very important thing which we have to mind it and always remember while solving questions. So let us solve some questions. Students, now evaluate under root minus 100 into under root minus 36. What will be the value of this? Under root minus 100 into under root minus 36. Students, here both numbers are negative. So we will use the property under root minus a into under root minus b equals to minus under root ab. This property will be applicable here. So easily we can write under root 100 into under root 36. And since we know under root 100 equals to 10, and under root 36 means the square root of 36 is 6, and this is equals to 60. This is the value of under root minus 100 into under root minus 36 equals to 60. What is missing here? It is minus, because this property we have not applied here. In hurry we may write like this, because always we know minus into minus gives plus. This will be wrong. So how can we write? We should put minus here, because what is our property? Property is under root minus a into under root minus b equals to minus under root ab. So here minus would be. So we will write here minus 10 into 6. Square root of 100 is 10, and square root of 36 is 6. So this will be equals to minus 60. This is your correct answer. This is your correct answer. I hope you are understanding this. Let us solve. minus 10 into under root 5. Here both numbers are not negative. Only one number is negative. So we will use the property under root minus a into under root b equals to under root minus ab. Under root minus ab. And this gives under root minus 12 into ab, and this will be equals to I under root ab. This will be I under root ab. So here what we will write? We will write I under root 10 into 5, and this will be equals to I under root 50. Now solve some other questions. We have to evaluate minus 6 into under root 7. So we will again use this property and write I under root 6 into 7, and this will be equals to I under root 42. Okay students, I hope you are getting. Students, if there will be any problem, you can ask in comment box. Thanks.